the chairman of the Consumer Association of Pakistan, Mr. Kaka, the guest of honor, the Consul General of Malaysia, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. It is a matter of great honor and privilege for me to be here today. And I thank the Consumer Association for providing me this opportunity to address this August gathering. Consumer Association is there all over the world. And as commodities came in the market and people realized that there is a commodity, when the during its evolution, then you had to protect those commodities, and it had to be made sure that people don't misuse the commodity, and eventually it gave rise to commodity associations all over the world. Pakistan, in its nascent history, and with the effort of people like Mr. Cocker, also processed, and now it has already been explained that we are far ahead in providing the commodities to the common man, made available to the common man at a reasonable cost. The awareness has to be created amongst the masses to be aware of such situations, of such commodities, and it is the job of the Consumer Association to guide the people, to bring awareness to the people that what they mean, what is to be done, because there are miscreants everywhere who try to derail the system. No health system in the world can survive without government support. In this fourth healthcare meeting, which the CAP is holding, it is very unfortunate that Pakistan has not even reached 2% of its GDP in healthcare, providing to the people of Pakistan. There is a gap, and a lot is desired from the governments to come forward to improve the healthcare. It's become so technologically advanced, medicine, it has now come to its nth level, where work on genetics has now started. Everything is going to be genetic based. Your medicines will be tailor-made according to your data, genetic data. Your treatment will be accordingly. So we have to do a lot of reading, a lot of research, and love up an upgradation of our own healthcare system, which requires a lot of money. The governments must work forward and come forward to help the people of this poor country. Medicine is something which was always required by mankind and has been there in some form or the other since man came on earth. They used some kind of medicine with different names, with different elements, with different things. They researched, they used, and then they came finally to what we call as medicine. Penicillin started, which came in 1920s, started a new era as the first antibiotic. In about 100 years, I think we have exhausted all the antibiotics and we have reached the last level. And I hope that we can produce something similar where antibiotics become more effective. The concept of medicine was there in Islam also. In Quran, I don't remember which verse, it said, from the belly of the bee, we shall produce, give you colored medicine. And now we know that honey is an antiseptic. It is now used to cover wounds, especially the burns, where it is a good healer because it contains a lot of vitamins and it contains antiseptic properties. As far as the pharmacy is concerned in Pakistan, that is also in its stage of growth. And as Mr. Iqbal mentioned, there is a metric pass, there is an interpass. We are not, unfortunately, only produce pharmacists. You have to have a second tier of pharmacists called as assistant pharmacists with 2 years of training after metric. Unfortunately, Sindh and Balochistan are the two provinces which do not have this. And neither the governments have taken any action on producing these people, especially to go into far-flung rural areas, who can at least dispense drugs to the man. And I also go one head further, as it's happening in America, that pharmacists are allowed to prescribe some medicines in certain diseases. Our system is very complex. Its evolution is very slow. We are lagging behind with the world societies. Our production, manpower should be our strength. That is the greatest resource we have. But unfortunately, we see our population as a source of embarrassment to us and call ourselves as an overpopulated country, but we should learn to harness this large population and use them to our benefit. In the end, I would like to thank you all for being patient and listening to me, and I hope that I have told you something which is worth remembering and working on amongst ourselves. Thank you.